we can tone down the rhetoric that has gone on, that has proliferated this type of violence and incited this type of violence. But more importantly, we can be more proactive in doing the things that we do and making sure that we can secure all New Yorkers, and that when we secure all New Yorkers, in particular as we come to our Eid celebration, we want to make sure that all of the Muslim communities and the masjids are safe and that they are protected, as all communities are during holy times. Certainly, we want to be able to address that. But far beyond that, this is not about one day or one week. This is about people being safe, that citizens in New York City are being treated equitably, and that we as a community, as a city, stand behind the Muslim community, saying that we condemn any kind of violence perpetrated on any of our citizens. But in particular, we are here this morning to address the heinous crimes that have occurred within the Muslim community. And we want to ensure those members of the community that we as a community stand behind. The city council stands with them. And all our resources are going into being proactively ensuring their safety. And I think that's where we move forward. I think that's what this is.
From the 9/11 till today, if you look at how many Americans have been killed, more than 400,000 Americans have been killed in the United States of America by gun violence, as opposed to only about 4,000, a little more than 4,000 people, including 9/11, been killed by terrorists, both inside and outside of the country. Those who are Muslim, non-Muslim, because a terrorist, he's a criminal for us as a Muslim. If he's somebody does anything, any crime, whether he's a Muslim or non-Muslim, he's a criminal. So we would urge on behalf of Majlis Ashura that the media should emphasize on the facts. And we'd urge those politicians not to make the facts, but tell the facts. If you really are there to protect Americans, come up with policy and procedure in place where we can actually protect American lives. Not put your emphasis where it's convenient and what is the rhetoric that you're putting out, insinuating Muslims are the one who is perpetrating all this thing. The fact does not speak for that. So with that, we conclude today's news conference. We thank all of you to come. All of you